Obviously, I'm very old and I've done a lot of different things, but Warehouse 13 was certainly.
I was very disappointed when that went off the air.
You know, we were too, especially since I still got a son in college. So I was a bit disappointed, and the bank that has my mortgage was disappointed. But other than that, it was a family affair, and I'm sure you could tell from watching it. You guys know the show.
Yeah.
Some of them do. It was a family. Whatever you saw on screen was real. I mean, we loved each other. We fought and argued like a family. We cried together and laughed together every day. And it was one of those things, as an actor who'd been in the business for more decades than I, you know, care to mention, I was already at that point in my career thinking, I'm going to concentrate on writing and directing. I'd already directed 4 independent films. I'd written a play that eventually got on here in London 3 years ago at the Chocolate Factory. It was directed by Frank Oz, film director, and it was called Terrible Advice. And I was concentrating on that. I was, you know, concentrating on that part of my career, on writing. And out of nowhere, this Warehouse 13 happened, which is the life of an actor. Because those of us that are working actors, you know, we don't sit around with, like, movie stars with a dozen offers on the table. That's a rarefied universe that I know nothing about, you know. It really is a question of us working and going to meetings, going to auditions, competing for roles that we want to do, and making decisions that are good for us and good for the family at the same time. So suddenly this role came about, and it was a magical piece. Written by David Simkins, and then we had the amazing good fortune of bringing on this extraordinary man, Jack Kenny, who became our head writer and our showrunner, and he really was the father, the arty of the group, and he was able to instill us with a great sense. He called it a thriller-omedy because we'd have to walk this wonderful tightrope as actors, which had to do with farce, comedy, drama, suspense, tragedy, all usually in the same scene. And we also were proud of it. I mean, Eddie McClintock, who was Pete Latimer on the show, and I were the only two dads on the show, the only two people who had kids on the show. Cece has kids. Cece Pounder has kids. That were, you know, we were talking about the fact that we were proud of it, that a family could watch the show. You know, there were very few things on the air other than, well, there's some half-hour stuff, but hour-long stuff, anything like that, was usually, you know, some kind of music competition or a voice competition kind of show, like American Idol or, you know, Britain's Got Talent or whatever. That's when a family watches a show. But if you're talking about a drama or an hour-long drama, what shows can you watch with your kids and feel like you're not being talked up to? And this show had, you know, sexual innuendos on this level, and it had slapstick on this level, it had intellectual stuff on this level, it had references here, it was all over the place. And so, all over, for the last 5 years, it's been a tremendous pleasure. You notice you don't have to ask me any questions. For the last 5 years, it's been a pleasure to have people come up to us and tell us that that we made a difference to their families because they could watch it together. That really was moving to me. That's something that we could do for 5 years. I'm thrilled about that.